And you've got your own company that you were leading?
I do.
Do you have a good memory. Do you have a car?
We can always cut to things.
Please. Yeah. It's called, what is the name?
It's called House of Murgatroyd Entertainment.
Do you love that title, ladies and gentlemen?
The House of Murgatroyd.
And you're Murgatroyd?
I'm a Mad Margaret, but the family in the story is the Murgatroyds. So if you go to www.thehouseofmurgatroyd.com.
How do you spell Murgatroyd?
M-U-R-G-A-T-R-O-Y-D. Murgatroyd. Okay. Yeah. And
I just love it. It sounds fascinating.
Does it?
Tell me more.
Well, we put together a production. We got a bunch of New York City actors together, and we got them over to England, and we debuted the production at the International Gilbert and Sullivan Festival in England. And I co-produced and co-wrote it with my writing and producing partner David Macaluso. And
he's wonderful.
Yeah, he's wonderful. He's one of my colleagues. Yeah.
Just tell him I said hello.
I will do that. I will. And we took this huge production that normally has about 40, 50 people in it. We wheedled it down to 7 people in this production. Brought it over to England. We had no idea whether they would like it or not, and they loved it. So it was,
it was quite a success. So critical.
They are. I'll tell you a funny
story about that. Especially if you're doing their work.
Their work, exactly. And they, so this was slightly terrifying, as you can imagine. But what's great, I was over there actually performing with the National Gilbert and Sullivan Opera Company, which is the English company over there that performs Gilbert and Sullivan. I was touring with them. We put this production up at the Gilbert and Sullivan Festival, and it's as a performer going in there, we're used to these great New York audiences, great American audiences. And after you finish a piece, the applause sort of goes up, it climaxes, and it comes down, and you sort of listen as a performer when to start with the next line or when somebody else comes in. And we didn't realize this. I knew it because I had been performing over there, but British applause is a little different. It's a little flatter. It doesn't sort of peak and then come down. It's just, if they like something, they just applaud and applaud and applaud. And David and I said, we've got to remember to tell our performers that are coming over there performing the first time to wait for that type of applause. And we got up there, we completely forgot to tell them this. So I finished my aria, the Mad Margaret's aria. She sings this wonderfully crazy Ophelia type crazy entrance aria into this thing. And they loved it. And then the girl who comes in next is Rose Maybud. She sort of has to cut off the applause and start the scene. And she couldn't come down. I mean, they were just applauding and applauding and applauding and applauding and applauding.
People tend to applaud you a lot.
Well, thank you. But it was such an education in, how the British listen to theater as opposed to, New York audiences.
And
how appreciative they are.
And you have a very interesting ethnic background.
I do. I'm half Irish, hence the name, Caitlin Burke. But I'm half Taiwanese too. My mother's from Taiwan. And I grew up speaking Mandarin Chinese. I don't know if you know that.
That's a little fun fact.
Yeah.
Can you say hello to the viewers in Mandarin?
Sure, ni hao.
Oh, that wasn't hard.
That wasn't hard at all. Yeah,
you can go from
that's
there.
How are you? Yeah. Right, exactly.
How?
Ni
okay.
hao. Yeah, that's sort of general. How are you?
So, wow, growing up in a Mandarin Chinese English household.
Yeah, my father looks like Santa Claus. He's very Irish looking,
yes,
New York Irish.
Yes. He looks like Jimmy Breslin.
Does he really? Yeah.
The old columnist.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes. Or I should say the late columnist, Jimmy Breslin.
Right. Yeah. And a little Richard Attenborough, a little bit, big beard. But yeah, my mom also speaks Taiwanese, speaks English, and speaks Mandarin. And yeah, it's just, we grew up, my father's
Taiwanese is different than Mandarin?
Different dialect, yes. Yeah.
I know nothing.
That's okay. but yeah, so my father speaks, his Mandarin is flawless, even though he looks like an Irish Santa Claus. But his Mandarin is flawless. So we grew up speaking Mandarin at home.
Does your mother do Chinese cooking?
Oh, she's an incredible cook. I mean, I'm going to get to go
Chinese
and eat
food.
Her food in a little bit for my birthday.
I was going to say, it's your birthday. What are you doing for your birthday?
I'm spending it with my family. This is the first time that I've actually been in the city and been able to spend it with them. I've been on tour for the last two years.
I said hello.
Yeah, I will. I absolutely
will. And so do all the viewers of the studio.
I will. Thank you.
Now, if you had to guess what your mother was going to surprise you with for your birthday dinner, what would you?
Well,
I know Chinese food very well.
Yeah.
As well as you do, I'm sure.
No, she makes mi fun, which is it's served in Chinese restaurants all over the place, but it's like rice noodles.
Yes, I know. I eat it all the time.
Yeah, it's very good.
I thought it was May fun, but maybe I'm wrong.
That's probably a Cantonese pronunciation. Oh, no. But I have to tell you, my mother also can make incredible Irish food because we had corned beef and cabbage last week for St. Patrick's Day.
And she makes a mean soda bread.
Oh, yeah.
God.
It's incredible. Yeah.
A well-fed household in
Queens. Well, absolutely.
And you own the building, I think?
That was my grandmother's house. Yeah, we did.
It's
your
grandmother's house, and you still live there.
Yeah, wow. I don't live there anymore. I did live there for a long time.
Because you just got married, I think.
I did. I got married.
Congratulations again.
Thank you.
Really rocking it.
Rocking.
I know. I'm looking through my Facebook pages, and suddenly, she got married.
I got married, and then I went right on the Sound of Music tour, for the national tour of the Sound of Music, for 2 years.
I guess you were singing "You'll Never Walk Alone."
Or "Climb Every Mountain."
Oops.
Yeah, I just did it at the Kennedy Center. It was a thrill. First time performing.
Wow!
At the Kennedy
Center. Did you do the whole show, or just your song?
The whole show. Yeah, we did the whole beautiful. It was directed by Jack O'Brien, 3-time Tony Award winner.
Jack's been on the show again.
Has he really? He's wonderful.
He's wonderful.
And Andy Einhorn is the musical supervisor. Jane Greenwood to the gorgeous.
Everybody
costumes.
Wants you, Kathleen.
I don't know if everybody wants me, but we had a great time. It was a great. Natasha Katz did the lighting design.
You're the busiest actress I know.
Oh, you're sweet. I try to keep busy. It's
you do.
I go crazy if I don't.
But
keep
you
busy,
tour. So. You tour all the time. Some people don't like touring.
Yeah, it was a great. I 2 years on the road, 60 cities in 2 years. It was incredible.
With the Sound of Music.
With Sound of Music and Canada, we were up in Ottawa and Toronto for a little bit too.
Oh, Canada.
Yeah.
I was a choir boy. I sang. I had a
choir. Did you really?
I did. Stint Help for the Boys.
I have a couple of projects. We're doing.
Please tell us. Everyone wants to know.
Yeah, we're going to mount the House of Murgatroyd, the small production. We're going to bring it to New York City. We've never done it in New York City.
Well, we'll see you again.
In the fall.
Yeah, and we're having.
Oh, great, perfect. We're having what we're calling a skip choir, sing choruses in public as a fundraising event. You can go to singchorusesinpublic.com and go check out this choir that's a donation-based choir for anybody to join. You can come and sing, show off your fabulous voice. Stephen Holt's voice.
That was almost the right thing.
That sounded great. So we're doing this. This is sort of the latest project that I'm working on, this skip choir. And we brought in a conductor from England. She's going to be conducting Gilbert and Sullivan choruses. You can actually learn how to sing Gilbert and Sullivan choruses with a British director, so it's kind of lovely and fun. And I can talk about the national tour a little bit. The Sound of Music.
Yes.
Yeah, it was the Equity Tour. It was great. It was so much fun. And it was great people to work with. It was so nice to work on a classic musical with Jack O'Brien, who is
it's
the creative team for Carousel.
Yes,
opening very soon on Broadway.
Almost instantaneously.
By the time the 7-hour interview is over, Carousel's going to be open.
It's just heaven. It goes quite like this.
It does.
When you've got a star.
When it's old friends.
yeah.
But yeah,
I know. I feel like I've got to write an opera for you, and I have.
Well,
but
you
anyway,
have. I know.
But we won't talk about
brilliant.
That. Oh, really?
I loved
really?
It. So,
well,
I thought it was great.
Some. I guess I could say the title.
Yeah, go for it.
I Love My Voice, the first neurotic opera.
I love it.
And she's the only one in it. But anyway,
I know. That says about me, but that's a great title.
I love that title. You know, it's the perfect thing if you to tour.
Right, exactly. It is. It's the cheapest touring production.
I've never heard her sing it, but I just know it's fabulous. Anyway, and you had something else that you wanted to talk about.
I think that we've talked about the skip choir that we're doing, the House of Murgatroyd. can check these out at both of the websites.
And what?
Oh, in Reading Gorge. I talked about Reading Gorge. April 14th and 15th at the K Playhouse. And you can go to NYGASP.org for tickets.
NYGASP, which is the
New York Gilbert and Sullivan Players.
Yeah. And the K Playhouse.
K Playhouse is up up near Hunter College.
Right, it's just sort of in the middle. One day I
Danny
went to
Danny K Playhouse.
I think I went to see the last thing I saw up there.
Well, you
Pinafore. I went to see Pinafore,
but
you weren't in it.
I wasn't in that one. No.
But it was a very good Pinafore.
That's a beautiful production too. They do a great job. That's a beautiful.
Give three cheers and one cheer more for the intrepid captain of the Pinafore.
Exactly.
You know, when I first told my mother was I was a little kid and I wanted to be an actor, and she was very upset about this. She said, "Well, if you're going to be an actor, you have to learn how to say, I am the very model of a modern major general." And then she took the whole thing.
That was exactly, when I was growing up, my father would sing all the patter rolls, and my sister and I would go, "We are sisters and cousins and sons, sisters and cousins and sons."
I know,
it's fun. It's fun for kids.
You sang.
A little bit. You got a little in there,
taste. Well, to see more of the great Caitlin Burke, and you'll see more of her on the show as time goes by, I'm so sure. The next thing is Reading Gorge
at the K Playhouse, April 14th and 15th.
For
tickets, go to NYGASP.org.
And there's the address right there. I did go there before, but I got completely lost. Anyway, I found it eventually. Anyway, thank you so much.
Thank you,
and
Stephen.
Happy birthday, Caitlin.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Jad. Thank you.
Fudge.
Thank you, Jad. Thank you.